Hello friends, welcome to another video. In today's video, we are going to explore CrossFilter DAX function. This function is not very commonly used, but it is really, really powerful function. Let me actually show you guys in this particular video what we're going to do, like what problem we're going to solve using this CrossFilter DAX function. That's it. Let's take a look at Power BI. This question was posted in Power BI community forum. Basically, what we have here is we have two line graphs, and the first line graph is coming from the location table here and get filtered using these slicers. Keep in mind, this top graph is getting filtered based on the slicer, but the bottom one is not getting filtered, and the data in the bottom one is coming from the stages table. The reason why the bottom one is not getting filtered, because these slicers are coming from a table called locations, and the location table does not have any relationship with the stages table. Let me actually clear that showing the data model here. So if we go to the data model here, pretty straightforward. Location table has a relation with the levels. That levels is the one which is getting used in the top graph. Calendar dimension is the common dimension between these two fact tables, levels and stages. So basically, when we are filtering in the slicer any of using these columns, it is filtering our levels column table, and then the visual will change accordingly. And on x-axis, we have a date from the calendar table. Anything we filter on the location table will not filter stages table because it does not have any relationship. And that is also not required in this particular example. User does not want the stages table to be get filtered using the locations. Just quickly show you guys what's happening here. Let's see if I select one of the group here, group one. You will see the top visual is changing because it's getting filtered now only for those groups, but nothing is changing on the and the lower visual, and it's working perfectly fine. Now, what problem we are trying to solve here? If everything is working perfectly fine, what we're trying to achieve here? Now, the ask here is actually is when user select the a group in here or any of the slicer they use, this data is now changing depending on the slicer. Maybe the start date is for a group is different than selecting all the groups. Let me quickly show you guys here an example. Let's say if we select group 5 and we select Southwest, for example. If I go to the start of the graph here in the visual here, maybe actually let's change it to a table visual. Will be easy to see. Change it to table visual, and if you look at the date, it is starting from the 1st of April 2006, and if we select Northeast, and now the data is changing from 9th month, right? So that's a that is September. So basically what happens is, depending on the groups or the slicer we use, our date range, because that is that based on the selection, that is when the data is available for those dates. Now, what the user wanted is, he wanted the bottom graph should take the date range from the selection what we have made. Based on the slicer, get what is the minimum lower band, lower date, and the upper date, and then filter this graph for those dates only. Show this all the data, but only for those dates based on the dates get calculated in the top graph. So in other words, when we are filtering on, let's go to the data model. When we are filtering on the location table, it is filtering the level table. Let's say we are filtering on group 1, it has data only for 2008. But if we are not filtering on anything, let's say the whole data is starting from 2000 to 2023, or for one particular group, it is only available for 2008. And since we know the location table will not filter the stage table, it means if I'm filtering anything on this group, I need to find out what those dates are, upper and the lower bound dates are, minimum and the maximum date, and then filter my stage table for those dates. So the lower graph will filter for only those dates. Now, how are we going to do that? This is where the cross filter function is going to come in the picture. Let's look at the solution, how I did it. To showcase like what dates we need to work on to have our bottom graph to work, I just created another page just to give you a small demo here how the dates will get calculated. So if you look here, this is just a date column coming from the calendar table. Then I create two measures, level min date and level max date. Those are basically the min and the max from our level table. That is a min of the levels date time and the max. So that's what it is. So if you see right now, our min date is a 9th month, September, and the max date would be at the bottom, if you see, is the 23rd of February 2023. Again, this date will change depending on what groups we are working on. And everything looks great. So if you look at the card visual here, as you can see, the minimum date is this and the maximum is this. And if we go to the group 5, the minimum is 1st of 9th month and then the 23rd of February, right? So now, if you look at this, it looks like this is pretty simple from here onward. Once we know the date range, after the groups has been selected or other slicer has been selected, then we can filter our bottom visual based on that as well. That's very easy. So I created a measure just to showcase what the measure will look like. It's called stage measure 1. Basically what we are doing here is we are calculating the sum from the stage table, and then we are having keep filters. Again, I don't want to go in details why we're using keep filters here. Basically, again, the row context we want to be transfer over to the filter context so that it get filtered by the date. So what we are saying is the core here is filter our date table, which is calendar date table and calendar table dates between our minimum date and the maximum date. So what we are saying is whatever is my minimum and the maximum date is, filter my calendar table on that. And then because calendar table is now linked with staging table, so we expect the staging table data will change accordingly depending on the what group we selected. So if I go to the solution page, I just created another page here. Here in bottom visual, then I'm going to use this new measure which we just created, stage measure 1. And I know this is not going to work. And as you see, we will get this visual has exceeded the available resource error message. Again, this is a very, very small data set and we are doing a very simple calculation and we are getting this error. Now, the question is why we are getting this error, like for such a small and simple DAX. Let's go back to page 1 where we have a showing the minimum and maximum date by calendar date. And if you look at that, our minimum and maximum date is getting calculated in the context of the date, right? At the date level, even at the total level, this is perfectly fine. If I go and filter it sorted by date, at the without the context of the date, the range is perfectly fine. But if you look at the each date level, it is getting the minimum date of that date and the maximum of that date. So it's basically getting recomputed for each and every date because that's what the instructions we have in our DAX measure. Now, because of that relationship between between calendar table and the levels table, the solution here is that we just need to get the start and end date the range, which we know how we can get that, but we don't want that to be get filtered or recomputed at when we're looking at the date level. Why we don't want it to be get recomputed? And because when we are looking at the data in the bottom graph by date, we just want to find out the range and then we can work from there. So I already created two more measures to do that. And that's where the cross filter functions come in the picture. What that function is going to do is basically, we can actually change the direction of the filters. And one big thing we can do with that function, with the cross filter function, we can make the relationship inactive or not available at all. And that's what we want to do. We don't want this minimum and maximum date to be recalculated when we are looking in the context of the date. We just don't want to do that. And that's what I did in my another two measures, demo min date. Again, what I have is minimum levels date time. It's still the same, but then I'm saying cross filter between date table and the levels date time table on those two columns and make the relationship none. So that basically mark it as inactive or does not exist, whatever you want to call it. And similar for the max. So what does this mean is, when we are looking this min and max function in the context of the date, they will not get filtered. They will always give the start and end date range. Let's take a look at that. If I go to my table view again, instead of using the original measure which we created, level min one and level max, so I'm going to use this demo min and the demo min and the demo max. And now what you will see is these date ranges are now showing for same for each date. It's still the showing the minimum date and the maximum date. Like if I go to group five, because we know that has a starting of 1st of September, so it's giving me 1st of September to 23rd of February, which is minimum and maximum. Does not matter in the context of the date I'm looking at that. It is not filtering my, in this particular measures, it's not filtering our level table. And that's why we are getting these minimum and maximum date, same value for each date. And again, we use cross filter function to make that relationship inactive. Now, from here, it is pretty straightforward. What I have is another measure called stage measure. I just stored the demo minimum date and maximum date in a variable. Again, the core of the DAX function is still the same. I'm saying filter my calendar table on the start date and end date, which is minimum and maximum date, and then use keep filter to have a row context turn into the filter context. And then if I go to the solution page now, instead of using the stage measure one, we will use this stage measure. This is the new measure which we created. And this is working lightning fast. And as you will see, when I will select different groups, what is happening, maybe the starting and ending date is getting recalculated. And this graph will show us the data for those date ranges based on what we have selected here. So now this is what is working as expected. So you saw in this demo, we used a cross filter function to make a relationship inactive. There is another way to solve this problem. And I'm not going to talk about that. I'm going to give you that as in a homework or something to try on. So basically, the same result we can achieve without using cross filter function. I will hope you will try how you can solve that, and do put that in your solution in the comments. And again, we can have a discussion on the alternate solution, and I will post my solution after a few weeks. Again, do check out other videos on my YouTube channel. There's a ton of content in there. Also, I'm working on some other exciting videos. Do make sure to subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon so that you get to notified when the new videos come out. Again, thanks for watching. Until next video, have a great day. Thank you. Bye for now.